Welcome back to the Escapist Games Showcase Fall Edition. My name is Nick Landro, the editor-in-chief of the Escapist, joined by Jack Packard, who's a semi-professional game enjoyer, and now yes. Piotr, the Trash Sailors development team. Hello. So Piotr, welcome. If you can kind of introduce yourself a little bit and what you do for Trash Sailors.
Okay, so my name is Piotr. I'm one of two people working on this game. The second one, girlfriend Veronica. She drew all the graphics for the game, and I did everything else. The Trash Sailors is our second game, and it's action co-op for up to four players. You are playing as a castaway who managed to survive a giant trash tsunami which covered the whole world.
Did you say trash tsunami?
Yeah, trash tsunami, because people threw so many trash to the ocean that it makes a giant. So you start the journey on the small raft in the middle of the ocean, and you have to make your way through the whole all bizarre dangers and other things, and just survive. And during the journey, you have to collect garbage which is floating on the ocean and recycle it to create materials which are needed to run the engine, to patch the holes in the raft, and they also work as ammunition for the cannon.
This looks charming and wonderful. I'm a big fan of couch co-op. I know, like me and my kids, a lot of times we will play games like Lovers in a Dangerous Space-Time, which is also a multiplayer ship management game. And so this looks right up our alley. And the art direction is phenomenal.
Thanks. Actually, Lovers in a Dangerous Space-Time was one of our inspirations. To create game, great.
And so, like, I guess it's very self-explanatory. If you just watch the trailer, you kind of know what you're doing. But walk us through a gameplay scenario. Like you said, we're gathering trash to both use as ship repair and as weapons. Give us a little slice of what we can expect in the gameplay.
So we wanted to give a lot of mechanics and actions on the raft so everyone can find something that he's good at. So for example, you can steer the raft, you can collect garbage and produce resources, you can handle fighting and shooting cannons, you can also help with steering the raft by jumping on the edge of the raft, because balancing is one of way to steer it.
Oh, okay.
Not every characters are good at the fatter the character, the better. And also you can move and turn on the light in the night because some scary creatures will complete dark, so you have to navigate.
Is this like a linear adventure? Is it more like a roguelite, maybe?
It's quite regular, but you can upgrade the raft in two ways. There are regular upgrades, like you can upgrade your cannons, the hull, the steer, other things. Or you can upgrade it in a visual way. For example, you can add the carpet, the disco ball, and other.
Very important to have the disco ball. Absolutely.
Yeah.
This sounds great. I know, like, over on Steam, there is a demo of it available right now.
Yep.
That people can try. Of course, people can wish list it. I know it says that it's planning on releasing yet in 2020. Any firmer release date information that you have?
I can't give you the more precise date because right now we are working on online mode. The whole content is already added, and right now, as I said, we are working on online. It takes more time than we expected, but we are really hope that we'll manage to release it in the end of the on this year or on the beginning of the...
So what's the like failure state of the game? Do you go through, is it just level based, or do you, if you fail, do you have to start all over?
Yeah, it's level based. If you fail, that you have to restart the level, and you don't have to go through all the level.
So you said it was one of the inspirations was Lovers in a Dangerous Space Time. Is Overcooked another inspiration? Because I'm kind of getting the vibe of, you know, having to switch roles when things go wrong and.
Exactly, and Don't Starve a little bit.
Okay.
In the art style is maybe quite similar, and also Misadventures of Flapjack. I don't know if you know this card. It's not very popular, but it has really trashy art style, and dirty.
I was gonna say that's usually not a compliment. Oh, okay, yes, but I just quickly looked up a picture of the Misadventures of Flapjack, and yes, I know what you're talking about. It does have a dirty art style, yeah.
Yeah, we love that, and we thought that we can mix it with our game. I think it's quite nice.
Absolutely. Do you know if are you able to say if you will be bringing this to a console experience?
It's hard to tell right now. We want to release it also on consoles, but it depends on the deals that our publisher are making. So it's not my decision. I want to, but we'll see.
Of course, of course.
All right. Well, we're almost out of time, but what is the feature in this game that you are most excited about for players to experience?
I think I noticed that the feature that players like the most is just collecting the garbage. Like I wanted for example in tutorial I wanted the players to make things that are in tutorial, but most of the players just are just collecting garbage and don't listen to the tutorial. It's I mean, it's a good feature, but I don't know what's the best.
maybe you can't answer, but since the game is kind of about, you know, cleaning up garbage from water and all that, is Tiny Build doing anything with environmental like groups to help promote this game, or maybe like promote cleaning up garbage in our waterways?
Yeah, but you after that you will throw this trash back to the ocean by cannons or add it to the engine.
So definitely not.
Yeah.
Right, you're using the garbage as cannon fodder.
I missed that part.
Or you will burn it in the engine, so it's
right.
Even better. Cool. Alright. So we already answered when we can expect the game, and you answered what you're most excited about, and I think that's about it. So
perfect.
Thanks for stopping by, Piotr, and we look forward to showing off Trash Sailors during the showcase itself.
And thank you for having me.
You bet.
So, see you guys.